Zika, your single source since 1950 for quality, selection, reliability, and fast delivery. We want to congratulate you for buying a MIG-200 machine for electrode welding and continuous wire feed welding. Thank you for choosing Zika. Before we start, take a few minutes to read and understand the operating and safety instructions of the device. Please wear your safety and protective equipment before starting to work. The kit contains the MIG-200 welding machine, a cable and handle for welding of wires and spare parts for the handle, a cable and handle for electrode welding, an earth clamp and 1.5 meter cable, a gas tube, and CO2 regulator. Getting to know the machine. There are three controls on the front panel of the machine. An on-off switch to turn the machine on and off. A control to set the type of welding, MMA for electrode welding or MIG for continuous wire feed welding. A control for setting the wire thickness, 6/10, 8/10, or 1 millimeter. There are two displays. The upper one displays the voltage during welding. The bottom one displays the amperage during the operation. At the bottom of the panel, there are three controls. An output control which adjusts the amperage during welding. An arc control to adjust the arc length and to adjust the penetration in case of electrode welding. A voltage control for welding of wires. This control is used to adjust the voltage during welding. There is another control that allows taking the needle out as quickly as possible, especially in the initial stage of coil installation. Please note, this control can be used to save on gas during the initial installation of the coil. If you want to conduct wire welding, connect one end of the tube to the gas inlet at the back of the machine and secure with a band. Connect the other end to the CO2 regulator and secure with a band. Now place the regulator on the cylinder and connect it to the machine socket that is found at the back of the power supply. Please note, the supplied regulator is rated to 36 volts. If you use a 220 volt regulator, you must connect it to a 220 volt socket. A cable comes out from the machine and its purpose is to supply power to the MIG handle. Therefore, for MIG welding, you must take the cable coming out from the machine and connect it to the positive connector. Then take the earth connection handle and connect it to the negative connector. Now connect the CO2 handle to the designated connection. Please note, the connection is a European connection that fits almost all handles. Hold the handle close to the machine and screw it well in its place. Open the feeder cover. Release the wire clamp and open the guide wheel. There are two notches on the feed wheel, one for 8/10 wire and the other for 1 millimeter wire. Insert the selected diameter inward. Then open the coil cover and place the coil such that the wire will be fed straight from the coil to the feed wheels. In order to ensure smooth passage of the wire, note that the wire end is not damaged. If it is damaged, cut the end. Now you can see the motor and two drive wheels of the wire. Insert the wire through the guide into the feeder until it reaches the handle outlet and secure the clamp on the wheels. You must remove the nozzle and contact tip to allow the wire to pass through the handle freely at the outlet. Now insert the plug to a standard 220 volt socket and switch on the machine. Set the control to MIG welding. Use the control to quickly take out the wire until it is completely off the handle. Mount the contact tip back on the handle and then the nozzle. Now you are ready to weld. The operating instructions contain recommended welding data to ensure you get the best welding performance from your machine. Connect the welding handle to the positive or negative connector. For example, with Z316 electrodes, the welding handle is connected to the positive connector, and the earth connection handle is connected to the negative connector. And in the case of Zika 18, the welding handle is connected to the negative connector, and the earth connection handle is connected to the positive connector. Make sure to select the correct connection. Now set the control to MMA mode. Insert the plug into a standard 220-volt socket and switch on the machine. Now you are ready to weld. The operating instructions and Zika's technical manual contain recommended welding data. Make sure to follow these steps to be able to enjoy high-quality and professional MIG welding. For more information and to see the rest of our products, please visit zika-welding.com.